Atlantis and Houston on the big loop. The station is ready for undocking. PMA 2 departure prep steps 1 and 2 are complete.
This is Mission Control Houston, a look in Atlantis's flight deck. You can see pilot Alan Poindexter, who will be maneuvering Atlantis through the fly around today, also being assisted by Rex Walheim, and now the mission specialist Dan Tani at the left. The flight control team confirming the hooks now being driven out between the two vehicles. Undocking is imminent between the two spacecraft.
Alpha and Houston Atlantis, we have physical set.
Alpha acknowledges separation. Manual undocking. Command sent.
Alpha, Houston, physical separation confirmed.
This is Mission Control Houston. As you've heard, physical separation confirmed. 3:24 a.m. Central Time. The two vehicles making their way east of New Zealand.
Atlantis departing.
Space Shuttle Atlantis now about 40 feet away. This is a view from the orbiter. The pressurized mating adapter in view on the Harmony module. Space Shuttle Atlantis now just under 60 feet away from the International Space Station and continuing to distance at a rate of 2/10 of a foot per second. Pilot Alan Poindexter, a first-time space flyer in control as he's manually controlling the orbiter moving away from the orbiting complex, which is in the upper portion of your view. The Harmony module, the center module, and the pressurized mating adapter, the small compartment that connected the two spacecraft in the center of the view, and the Columbus Laboratory, now in its new home on the space station. That's the lower dark cylindrical module in this view, just lower left of center. And the flight control team here confirming they have commenced with the fly around. They've reached a distance of 400 feet and starting now with Alan Poindexter, the pilot, at the controls as they begin to maneuver above the International Space Station. The undocking and further distancing all going smoothly. They're continuing at a rate of about 1/10 of a foot per second. The undocking itself occurring about 3 minutes ahead of the scheduled nominal undocking time of 3:27 a.m. Central Time, and that was done just to enable ideal lighting conditions for this fly around, which is a video opportunity to get a good look at the orbiting complex and its new configuration with the Columbus Laboratory now attached to the International Space Station. This is a view from Space Shuttle Atlantis, now 440 feet away from the International Space Station. The two spacecraft just making their way off the east coast as they're traveling northeasterly over passing Uruguay. They're at an altitude of 189 nautical miles. Pilot Alan Poindexter at the controls of Space Shuttle Atlantis as he's commencing with the fly around activity. He'll continue to perform this lap around the International Space Station, getting good visuals and video documentation of the orbiting complex before performing the two separation burns that'll further distance the two spacecraft and position the space shuttle in a good holding position as they continue with the inspection activities, a final check of the thermal protection system for Atlantis. It'll also keep it within a distance to enable it to re-rendezvous with the International Space Station should it be needed if there had been any damage to the thermal control system. This is Mission Control, Houston. This is a look from the screens of the flight control room, the shuttle flight control room located at the Johnson Space Center. And this is a graphical depiction of the current position of the orbiter in relation to the International Space Station as it's maneuvering to a position above the International Space Station, a distance about 476 feet as it's making its way over what is technically called the negative R-bar, or the position directly above the orbiting complex. It'll continue to rotate around the International Space Station, re-intersecting with the V-bar behind the International Space Station, and then move below before resuming its initial position ahead and then performing the separation burns. Now empty at the Columbus Laboratory, which is now added to the International Space Station, its new home in space. Also in view, the extended robotic arm and the orbiter boom sensor system, a 50-foot extension with special cameras and lasers at the end. They'll be using that for the late inspection or a final check of the thermal protection system later today, and all that imagery will be further reviewed by specialists to ensure there hasn't been any on-orbit damage of the thermal protection system that would cause a concern for re-entry. A good view of Space Shuttle Atlantis, just under 700 feet away, and just intersecting with the negative V-bar axis, directly behind the International Space Station, following in its direction of flight. The two spacecraft at 180 nautical miles above as they're passing on a northeasterly course over Algeria.
Alpha Houston, spacer ground 2 for PMA 2, depress.
Was done just to enable ideal lighting conditions for this fly around, which is a video opportunity to get a good look at the orbiting complex and its new configuration with the Columbus Laboratory now attached to the International Space Station. This is a view from Space Shuttle Atlantis, now 440 feet away from the International Space Station. The two spacecraft is making their way off the east coast as they're traveling northeasterly over passing Uruguay. They're at an altitude of 189 nautical miles. Pilot Alan Poindexter at the controls of Space Shuttle Atlantis as he's commencing with the fly-around activity. He'll continue to perform this lap around the International Space Station, getting good visuals and video documentation of the orbiting complex before performing the two separation burns that'll further distance the two spacecraft and position the space shuttle in a good holding position as they continue with the inspection activities, a final check of the thermal protection system for Atlantis. It'll also keep it within a distance to enable it to re-rendezvous with the International Space Station should it be needed if there had been any damage to the thermal control system. This is Mission Control Houston. This is a look from the screens of the flight control room, the shuttle flight control room located at the Johnson Space Center. And this is a graphical depiction of the current position of the orbiter in relation to the International Space Station as it's maneuvering to a position above the International Space Station, a distance about 476 feet as it's making its way over what is technically called the negative R-bar, or the position directly above the orbiting complex. It'll continue to rotate around the International Space Station, re-intersecting with the V-bar behind the International Space Station, and then move below before resuming its initial position ahead and then performing the separation burns. Now empty of the Columbus Laboratory, which is now added to the International Space Station, its new home in space. Also in view, the extended robotic arm. Space Shuttle Atlantis now just under 60 feet away from the International Space Station and continuing to distance at a rate of 2/10 of a foot per second. Pilot Alan Poindexter, a first-time space flyer, in control as he's manually controlling the orbiter moving away from the orbiting complex, which is in the upper portion of your view. The Harmony module, the center module, and the pressurized mating adapter, the small compartment that connected the two spacecraft in the center of the view, and the Columbus Laboratory, now in its new home on the space station. That's the lower dark cylindrical module in this view, just lower left of center. And the flight control team here confirming they have commenced with the fly around. They've reached a distance of 400 feet and starting now with Alan Poindexter, the pilot, at the controls as they begin to maneuver above the International Space Station. The undocking and further distancing all going smoothly. They're continuing at a rate of about 1/10 of a foot per second. The undocking itself occurring about 3 minutes ahead of the scheduled nominal undocking time of 3:27 a.m. Central Time, and that was done just to enable ideal lighting conditions for this fly around, which is a video opportunity to get a good look at the orbiting complex and its new configuration with the Columbus Laboratory now attached to the International Space Station. This is a view from Space Shuttle Atlantis, now 440 feet away from the International Space Station. The two spacecraft is making their way off the east coast as they're traveling northeasterly over passing Uruguay. They're at an altitude of 189 nautical miles. Pilot Alan Poindexter at the controls of Space Shuttle Atlantis as he's commencing with the fly-around activity. He'll continue to perform this lap around the International Space Station, getting good visuals and video documentation of the orbiting complex before performing the two separation burns that'll further distance the two spacecraft and position the space shuttle in a good holding position as they continue with the inspection activities, a final check of the thermal protection system for Atlantis. Off the east coast as they're traveling northeasterly over passing Uruguay, they're at an altitude of 189 nautical miles. Pilot Alan Poindexter at the controls of Space Shuttle Atlantis as he's commencing with the fly-around activity. He'll continue to perform this lap around the International Space Station, getting good visuals and video documentation of the orbiting complex before performing the two separation burns that'll further distance the two spacecraft and position the space shuttle in a good holding position as they continue with the inspection activities, a final check of the thermal protection system for Atlantis. It'll also keep it within a distance to enable it to re-rendezvous with the International Space Station should it be needed if there had been any damage to the thermal control system. This is Mission Control Houston. This is a look from the screens of the flight control room, the shuttle flight control room located at the Johnson Space Center. And this is a graphical depiction of the current position of the orbiter in relation to the International Space Station as it's maneuvering to a position above the International Space Station, a distance about 476 feet as it's making its way over what is technically called the negative R-bar, or the position directly above the orbiting complex. It'll continue to rotate around the International Space Station, re-intersecting with the V-bar behind the International Space Station, and then move below before resuming its initial position ahead and then performing the separation burns. Now empty of the Columbus Laboratory, which is now added to the International Space Station, its new home in space. Also in view, the extended robotic arm and the orbiter boom sensor system, a 50-foot extension with special cameras and lasers at the end. They'll be using that for the late inspection or a final check of the thermal protection system later today, and all that imagery will be further reviewed by specialists to ensure there hasn't been any on-orbit damage of the thermal protection system that would cause a concern for re-entry. A good view of Space Shuttle Atlantis, just under 700 feet away, and just intersecting with the negative V-bar axis directly behind the International Space Station, following in its direction.